came to win, to fight, to conquer, to thrive. I came to win, to survive, to prosper, to rise.
What up, what up, what up? It's your boy E.T. Welcome to another edition of Let's Bring It Down From Here, baby. Thank God it's Monday. That's right. Remember, I told you Monday is where you make your dreams become a reality. That's right. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And then on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, you get that rest. All right. Now, look, forgive me. Last week, we were in the island, the beautiful island of Bermuda, getting it in. All right. So we didn't have an opportunity to bring you Thank God It's Monday. All right, but look. We were in miracle territory. And so we're going to give you this week, next week, a couple snippets from Boston and Harvard and then Bermuda. But right now, I got a special edition for you. You got to bring it in, baby. I got a special edition for you. I got two principles I have for you today. All right, two principles. Now I want to talk to somebody out there because you've been watching me the last couple years. You've been watching me the last couple months and you still in lack. Listen to me, I wanna say this to you, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart, man, you deserve better, all right? There's some of you still going to the gas station and you putting in half a tank of gas when you know you need a full tank of gas, all right? There's still those of you, on your charge card or if you have your a phone bill you have to pay. For some reason, you still just giving them enough so you can keep it on and you're not living in the abundance, all right? Like, you're not where you want to be in life. And listen to me, at some point in life, you have to tell yourself, because you don't make the adjustment, you don't make the shift in life until you get to the point where you say enough is enough. And listen to me, you deserve better. I heard a song that said, you deserve more than the usual, all right? And so you got to stop this, you're eating peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, not because you got a goal, not because, you're trying to get to the next level, so you're making sacrifices. Like, you eating peanut butter and jelly because you have not declared to yourself that you're going to do what you have to do to give yourself the best life you can have. Now, some of you deserve to be doctors. Let's flat out. You in college and you're not doing what you're supposed to do. There's some of you at your job. You deserve a promotion. But for some reason, you still giving half effort. You still putting forth 75, 85%. You deserve better. All right? You'd make a much better teacher than you would a high school dropout. Listen to me. You make a much better millionaire than you would a welfare recipient. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You deserve better. And how do I know? Because I've been there. I've done that. You read the book. Some of you read the book. All right? You see how I was in my teenage years, my young adult life. And then one day the kill switch came, bah, and boom, I took off. And so I'm saying to you before I give you my two principles, when you are finished watching this TGIM, I want you to go look in the mirror. I don't care if you're in the car, look in the rearview mirror. I don't care if you're at work, go to the bathroom. I don't care if you're at home, go get in the shower. Go to the bathroom and look at yourself in the mirror and say flat out, you deserve better, right? You know, sometimes I sign in my book, Never Settle for Less. And there are those of you who are, look at your relationships, you're settling. Look at your career, you're settling. You would make a much better, and I know I said it, but repetition deepens the impression. You'd make a better millionaire than you would a welfare recipient. You make a better millionaire than you would just barely getting by, making 30, 40,000. You like right there on the poverty line. You make a better millionaire. You make a better doctor, a better lawyer, a better teacher, a better activist, a better wife. I don't know, a better husband, a better son. I don't know. I'm just saying, stop settling. Stop settling for less. You deserve the best. You do not deserve the usual. All right. So now that I got that out of my system, right? You can tell that was burning me up, right? I know. All right, so I got two questions for you. The first question is, how would your life, because I'm trying to help you to get past lack. I'm trying to help you get past the usual. I'm trying to help you to get past mediocrity, all right? And so two questions I want you to ask yourself, because I believe if you ask yourself these questions and you deal with the reality of these questions, that you're going to go to the fourth quarter living. And what's that? That's maximum living, baby. That's squeezing every ounce out of the lemon to make that lemonade. We're talking about getting everything life has to offer. All right, so my first question to you is this. How would your life be different if you were living by faith and not by fear? Yep, you heard me. I'm gonna say it slower. How would your life look different? How would your life be different? What would you have that you don't have right now? What would you be doing that you're not doing right now? What type of experience would you have that you're not experiencing right now if you didn't live off of fear, but you lived off faith? Now, like I said before, this ain't stuff that I'm talking about. I've lived it. Again, been there, done that. I'll never forget. I've not shared this before really in public, but it took me so long to get a degree. It wasn't about being dumb, all right? Listen to me, a lot of it was fear. You know, I told myself, for real, man, if I graduate with a four-year degree, you know, I was afraid of success. You know, I was so used to living off of, you know, just getting by, just paying my bills, just getting by. That was my life, that I was afraid when I graduate, could I handle success? Imagine that. There are those of you who are watching me right now. You have a fear of success. Some folks have a fear of failure. You have a fear of success. You are afraid. You are afraid to be successful. You've been broke so long that it's become a part of who you are. You've been in lack so long. You've been in poverty so long. You've not been able to go and splurge. You have not been able to go and enjoy life to its fullest. And you are afraid. You are afraid to be successful. You are afraid to succeed. Now, there is another group. You're watching me. You're watching me. You are afraid. Afraid of what? You're afraid of failure. You're afraid of trying. You prefer to say, well, if I don't try, then I could always say that I could have done it if I wanted to do it. All right? And I challenge both groups. I challenge those of you who are afraid of success to give it a shot. All right, and I challenge those of you who are afraid of failure, just give it a shot, just try. You will be shocked at what you can do. Now, I want you to live by faith. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I want you to live by faith, because when you live by faith, there are things that you can do. There are things that you will accomplish. All right, so I'm gonna tell a quick story before I go to my next one. We just left Harvard, right? I know, I'm tripping. Your boy E.T., I can't believe it. From high school dropout to going and presenting at Harvard University. Then we left Harvard Sunday morning and went to Bermuda. Are you hearing what I'm saying? All right, so this is what happened. I told my crew, between Harvard and Bermuda, we're gonna sell 500 books. We shipped for free because of faith. We shipped 500 books. 500 books to our hotel. Now, mind you, you gotta hear what I'm saying. If we don't sell them, we can't take them to Bermuda with us. It's only so many books we could take in our luggage. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I said, bring all 500 books. We sold 105 to one organization. I'm sorry, 125 to one organization. We went to a school and we just happened. Man, you're not hearing what I'm saying. Live by faith. I just happened 2 months ago to speak at a conference outside of St. Louis. It just happened that a group of kids who went to a high school who were present, their campus is right there on the campus of Harvard. You're not hearing me. I go and speak. The principal says, you got a book? I said, yeah. He says, is it out? I said, yeah. He says, I want some. I said, we happen to have 150 extra at the hotel. He said, bingo, I'm going to pick them up. I'm buying them. We go to Bermuda, we sell out in 2 days, 300 books. By faith, we sold 500 books. Are you hearing what I'm telling you today? I'm saying I live by faith now. I don't live by fear. Bring all 500, and guess what? We will sell all 500. How do I know? Because the just shall live by faith. And I want you to experience a life you've never experienced before. I'm going to ask you another question. Same question. What would your life look like if you weren't always afraid? What would your life look like if you weren't a scary cat and professionally? If you weren't a scary cat in relationships? If you weren't a scary cat financially, right? If you weren't a scary cat in your dreams and in your mind? If you weren't always living in fear, how much more would you have? How much more would you do? All right, y'all, here go my final one. I told you, we sold 500 books and two presentations. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So here go my last one. I want you to listen to this one. You got to catch this one. What would your life look like? Listen to me. What would your life look like if you followed your heart if you followed your heart and didn't listen to what other people had to say to you? What would your life look like if you followed your passion? That thing that you believed in, that thing that you're passionate about, that thing that means the most to you. What would your life look like? And I'm gonna tell you what it would look like. You would go from being a high school dropout, you would go from a person that takes 12 years to get a 4-year degree to speaking at Harvard University. You should have been there. All right, Shakara probably gonna show you a clip, and next week we'll give you a snippet of it. But when I was at Harvard, I couldn't believe that this is the same kid who was a high school dropout, who now, the only thing that's changed is I'm following my passion. And now I'm at Harvard University talking to college students, talking to adult change agents in the city, talking to high school students who are change agents in the city. Are you hearing what I'm saying? We wake up the next day, we're in Bermuda on a beautiful island. You read the book, chapter 15, I think it is, about Bermuda. In 1993, I went to talk to students. I came back. This time, when I came back, we spoke to every single teacher on the island. Are you hearing what I'm saying? How has my life changed? Because I follow my passion now. I'm not concerned about what people say. Listen to me. You got to shut other people off. Guess what? It's their opinion of you. And their opinion of you does not shape what you should have. It doesn't shape what you can do. It can't shape what you can be. Listen to me. It's just their opinion. What's going to shape you? What's going to change your life? What's going to revolutionize who you are? Is you following your heart, following your passion. So it's your boy E.T. Listen to me very closely. You got to hear what I'm telling you. You got to hear what I'm telling you. You can have whatever you want. You can be whatever you want. You can do whatever you want. But you got to ask yourself a serious question. If I wasn't a scary cat, that's right, I'm challenging you. If I wasn't a punk, if I wasn't afraid, if I wasn't fearful, if I lived by faith, what more could I accomplish? What more could I have? And finally, if I stop listening to other people, why am I so concerned about what they think? It's not what they think that makes me or break me. It's who and what I think about myself that determines my destiny. And so I need you to do me a favor. I need you to live by passion. I need you to follow your heart, because if you follow your heart, it's half the battle. Hey, I'm out of here. Remember, it's not your past that determines your present and determines your future. Right? It's you saying, I'm going to make the rest of my life the best of my life. So forget the mistakes, forget the past, and again, make the rest of your life the best of your life. It's your boy E.T. I'll see you next week. In 1993, and you got to read the book. I'm not going to tell the whole story, but a family, the James family, they just knocked on my door one day and gave me 2 free tickets to Bermuda and said, we want you to come here and speak. I was 22 years old. I remember going into the school systems, going into the prisons, going into the youth detention centers. I remember how, you know, individuals embraced me. And so listen to me very closely. You got to hear what I'm saying. I'm touching thousands of people across the world. And every chance I get, I tell young people about my experience when I came to this island, how I left. I came a child, somebody who was afraid. And I went back home like, I can do this. Shh, I was never the same. And why did I start with this story? Because if Bermuda could give me that type of push, if a counselor here in this environment could spark a high school dropout, a somebody who now is creating change around the world. When I sold my book, we had more people buying from Australia and Denmark, New Zealand, Switzerland, the UK. Why? Because one individual told me, before the whole world told me who I was and what I could be, that I could do it.
These past 2 days, you know, have been awesome. I feel like it has been the best ever. Absolutely. That we've ever had. Absolutely. And what I take away from both days is passion.
I can say without any doubt that this was one of our most powerful presentations by a keynote speaker.
He invites you into the corridors of his life, into his children's lives, his home, and he takes you into just a haven, a resting place of passion. That's really what it is.